looking at past trends, we can guess that we're going to be wanting to send more and more data at higher and higher rates. So if you upload a video to Facebook, for example, Facebook is storing your video until someone asks for it. So if you suddenly say, now I want to see my dog bouncing down the hall again, now Facebook has to figure out where they stored it and get all that data and bring it right to your computer almost as fast as you ask for it. Or if suddenly this video goes viral and everybody across the United States wants to see your dog bouncing down the hall, Facebook's got to be able to figure out how to get that data to everybody as fast as they can as soon as people ask for it. We're running up against the limit of what electricity can do. Regular electric wires, you try to get more and more data on there, they start to heat up, and the wires also start to interfere with one another. And so what we've found is that if we send data down these fiber optics made out of glass that can transport light from one place to another, then suddenly we can fit a lot more information on one strand of glass than we ever could on a wire. We want to try and use those same advantages that we got from fiber optics, not only between computers, but now within computers as well. We want to make lasers that are about 100 times thinner than the diameter of a single human hair. So these lasers need to be microscopic to fit in well size-wise among all the other microscopic components on a chip. And so there's lots of researchers who are working on how to shrink all these components down and get them to talk to each other. The lasers that we're making now are actually circular, and that's called a whispering gallery laser. And it's named after the whispering galleries in cathedrals that have big domes. And if somebody is standing in the right spot, clear on the other side of the cathedral, they can actually hear you even if you whisper, because the sound waves are bouncing along the edge of this cathedral and reaching the listener on the other side. In the same way, in these circular lasers that we've set up, we actually have set up our cavity so that the light bounces around the edge of the cavity and ends up at the original spot right in step with itself. The pictures are pretty too, actually. So as I'm sitting there at my computer sort of testing out these different laser designs, I get to see these pictures of flowers and these sort of wonderful circularly symmetric patterns coming up on my screen, and that's very satisfying.
You think you have problems with dust? Click on the video to see how scientists deal with it, and be sure to subscribe to Figure 1.